Praise all of All of the glory. great way maker. You're the great way maker. Ooh, always make a way back to the Father. You always make a way. His name is Jesus, the great way maker. His name is Jesus. Oh, you always make a way back to the Father. Yes, there is always a way back to the Father. Hey, you always make a way. You're God who is near to me, and you're not far away. Even when I stray, you are still not far away. Thank you, God, that you are near to us. You are never far away. We exalt your name tonight. We just declare that you are good. God, that you are near to us. God, no matter which way we turn and how far we run, God, you are but a name away, and his name is Jesus. God, you are so close to us, Lord, and we thank you for your presence. God, we thank you for your goodness. You overflow kindness, God. Lord, we thank you for who you are.
Be the mountain where I run. You are good. You're good.
'cause he is good, 'cause he is good. Yeah, it's just who he is. He is good, he is good. Yeah, it's just who he is. You're the very definition of love. You're the very definition. You defined love when you hung on that cross. Defined what love is for all eternity. You're the very definition of what love is. You defined what love is as you hung on that cross. You defined what love looks like as you gave your life. You defined it for all eternity. You said, this is what love looks like, and this is what love is. Laying down my life, this is what love is. You're the very definition of love, and that'll never change. Of love, and that stays the same. It stays the same. It stays the same. In this crazy world we live in, that definition of love never changes. Of love stays the same. In this crazy upside down world where we live, that definition of love, it will stay the same. 'Cause he defined what a love is for all eternity. It's laying down our own life, laying down. Topsy-turvy world where we live, where everything is fluid and everything seems to change. Oh, this one thing remains. The definition of love, it will stay the same. 'Cause he defined love once and for all. And you are never gonna let, you're never gonna let down. You're never gonna let, you're never gonna let us down. You're never gonna let, no, you're never gonna let us down. You're never gonna let, never gonna let us down. You remain the same, you never change from day to day. You're the rock where I build my house, 'cause everything else is shaking. good God you are.
Because of what you've done.
Lord, I thank you that all who are thirsty could come, Lord, all who are hungry can come. Lord, I thank you for the invitation tonight, Lord, to go deeper, to know you more, to know you like never before. For some people, if that's okay. Is that okay with you for just a second, Lindy? What's your name in the teal shirt? Pam, I kept seeing like butterflies all around you, and I felt like the Lord said that tonight he's come to what the butterfly used to represent to you. He's going to bring a whole new meaning tonight, and I really felt like it was just the love of the Father for you tonight. And that he was just coming with new beginnings. And so that the old things are past and new things have come, and that he's really going to spread your wings and there's a new day coming. And so anyways, I just want to bless you. It was Pam, right? So we just thank you for Pam. I want to thank you for the call on her life, Lord, that she's called to be a worshiper. God, I thank you that she'll be one, Lord, who knows what it looks like to rest in the secret place. Lord, I thank you that you've come tonight, Lord, to make all things new. Lord, I thank you that even the beautiful things, Lord, what they represented in the past, it's going to be a whole new meaning. Lord, and we bless her tonight. And then the man in the stripes in the back, what's your name? Johnny? Okay, well, you really stood out, and I really felt like the Lord had some stuff for you, and I thought, but I just getting little bits and pieces, and then all of a sudden, I just heard the name Enoch, and he said, I've called you to walk as Enoch walked, that he walked with God, and he was no more, and that the Lord is about to really set in place some theological thinkings and things. I feel like you're a real thinker, and the Lord's about to bring some alignment in every way, and you're really about to understand relationship even more so, and that you will be one with an Enoch call that will walk with him and that will know his heart, and you'll understand the whys, but you're also going to have relationship, which is a really beautiful balance. And I kept hearing him say, when I heard Enoch, I kept hearing he knocks, and I felt like he's come to knock on the door of your heart tonight. So anyways, and Johnny, right? So Lord, we bless Johnny. Lord, I thank you for the season, Lord, in his life, Lord, that you're ushering him in. God, that he will be one that will walk with you, and he will know you. That, Lord, and even in his thinking and his hunger to understand the theology behind it, Lord, that relationship will be, Lord, the key. Lord, I thank you for the relationship, Lord. But I thank you that he's going to know your heart. In Jesus' name. And I just kept seeing the love of the Father for you. I just kept seeing him wanting to wash over you, like in a whole new way, and just mess you up with the love. The love of the Lord is so good. It's so strong for you. And that's all. I was like, Lord, is that? And he was like, just let her know how much I love her. Like, I really, really love her. So just know, it's really sweet. But anyways, then the girl with the pony, the braid right here, I really kept seeing the Lord, that you're called to be one of the ones in this coming generation that is really going to walk with him. And I saw him like messing up your hair, and it's going to be a little messy sometimes. And maybe where you wanted things to be like ducks in a row, that he's about to come and mess you up a little bit, but it's going to be a really great thing, and that you're going to experience him in a whole new way, and you're really called to be a leader to the next generation.
And Bobby Connors had a really cool vision. I just thought about it recently, that he shared about this, about the millennials, and how the Lord was sending in this vision, it was like a bear, that the Lord was releasing this bear, but that was this bear was coming to bring order. And where they had been very just chill and like not wanting to just do what needed to be done, that the Lord was about to bring a spirit that's going to come over this next generation that picks up, does what the Lord's called them to do. That it's not just this like, oh, we'll just drink coffee and it's going to happen for us one day kind of a thing, if that makes sense. That there was actually, that wasn't a bad thing, but that the Lord was going to bring real order to it in a healthy way. And I keep seeing that on you for this next generation, that it's actually going to be a messy thing, but you're going to know how to bring things in place. So anyways, I know that feels like a lot. Does that feel like way over your head? Okay, good. So anyways, Lord, we just thank you for your presence here. Lord, I thank you for your heart. Thank you for our worship team. In Jesus' name. And we bless Pastor Tim, Ms. Susan, and Karen, and Jimmy, and everybody who's out. We bless John and Jared as they're in the youth, Lord, out there. Lord, our babies and our children. Lord, we bless our children. Lord, I pray for an outpouring, Lord, on our kids. Lord, I pray for an outpouring on our youth, that they are not forgotten. Lord, we just join right now tonight. Lord, I just feel your heart on that, Lord. We just lift up our kids and our youth right now, Lord Jesus, and we declare, Lord, that there will be an outpouring of your heart for our kids and our youth. Lord, I see their hunger and their thirst, Lord, to know you, to be with you. Tonight, I was trying to prepare for tonight, and anyways, if you can only imagine trying to get some quiet time with three little babies. And anyways, and June, my littlest, she kept coming in. She kept poking her head in, and I had tied like 15 bracelets. They were making bracelets, so I tied a bunch of bracelets, and June kept coming in, and she finally goes, she's like, oh, Mom, can I just sit here? I'll be so quiet. I just want to have quiet time too. And I was like, okay. I was like, but you have to really have quiet time. We really have to try. And she was like, okay. And so we're laying there in 2 seconds. 2 seconds goes by, and she leans over. She's like, you're so beautiful. I was like, thank you. This is our quiet time, though. She's like, oh, okay. I really love my bracelet. Oh, yes, I love your bracelet, too. Oh, I just love Jesus. And I was like, anyway, so that's about the gist of my quiet time today. But it was so sweet. And so anyways, I just thought about that when we were praying for our babies. They're so hungry. They love that. And it was just that sweet presence of the Lord that was there. Anyways, it wasn't great for preparing, but it was good. So anyways, thank you, Lindy. And she was like, okay, we're done. Okay, I'm going to get situated if y'all don't care, because we're going to do kind of like what we did last time. Is that cool with y'all? Hello. There we go. How are you? Thank you for your patience. So I really liked this last time. It felt very natural, so we're just going to do it again. Is that okay with y'all? Thank you. take this bracelet off. How was y'all's day? Good, good. I'm not going to keep you guys too long. Pastor Tim, you know, he's been sharing on the secret place. And so he asked me just to come hang out with you guys and share a little bit on the secret place. I'm so thankful for Lindy, because I would have put that in the wrong key. Okay, perfect. So I was just asking the Lord about what he wanted to share tonight, and just kind of what aspect I could bring on the secret place. These lights feel so bright. The Hebrew word is sather. I believe that's how you pronounce it. And it means to hide away or to conceal, to cover, to reveal secret things, and to be undetected. I really believe there's a real place tucked away that his heart, he's continually longing for us to meet him there. And so I just want to, just for a second tonight, let's just close our eyes. We're just going to give him attention, and we're just going to practice just resting in that secret place. Lord, I thank you that you're training us up in the ways, Lord, of your heart. Lord, that you're training up a people who know how to enter into the secret place. In Exodus 33, verse 20, it says, when Moses wanted to see the glory of the Lord explained that no one could and live. So God allowed Moses to see his glory, but only from a secret place. And in verse 22, it says, when my glory passes by, I will put you in the cleft of the rock, in the crest of the rock, and I will cover you with my hand until I pass. Because Moses stood on the mountain, waiting for you to pass by. And you placed your hand over his face, so in your presence he wouldn't die. All of Israel saw your glory just shine through all the age. And now you've called us boldly to seek your face. So show me your face, Lord. Show me your face. Then gird up my legs, that I might stand in this holy place. So show me your face, Lord. Oh, your power and grace. I will make it to the end. I can just see your face. Mm. So show me your face, Lord. Oh, show me your face. And gird up my legs. this holy place. So show me your face, oh, your power and grace, and I will make it to the end if I could just see your face. Make it to the end if we can just see your face. Yeah. Oh, we want to see you, Lord. Oh, we want to know you, Lord. Just see your face, oh, and we'll praise you till the end, until we see your face.
I'm so glad I made it through that, because if you know Don Potter's version, he's so wonderful. And the Lord told me to do it, and I was like, but Lord... Lord, I thank you for your presence. I thank you for the secret place. I really feel like there's seasons that the Lord will have us hide away and tuck away. You know, sometimes it's time. Can we turn up the pad just a hair? Is that okay? Thanks, Chad. There's just seasons where we can tuck away and really meet with him and be with him. You know, I really got to thinking about, you know, the Lord said he tucked Moses in the crest of the rock. And I started thinking about Jesus, and now it says Jesus is the rock. And it says, you know, he's also the door. It says to come to the Father, we must come through him. We must come through Christ. We must come through Jesus. And Lindy sang on that tonight. It was so good. And I thought, you know, it was really interesting in that picture with Moses. It was just such a picture of what the Lord was going to do. And that he tucked him away in the rock. And he tucked him away. For us, the rock looks like Jesus. And that was this really his only way of even just getting the slightest glimpse of the glory of the Lord was to be tucked away. So I know there are seasons that the Lord will hide us away and tuck us away, where we have to find ourselves in the rock, and we must go through that of knowing the place of knowing Jesus as the rock and as the door. And it's a place of refuge, and it's a place of safety for the times and the trials when you're going through different things in your life. You know, there's seasons of trial and hard times where the Lord covers and tucks away, and it's a safety thing. Have you ever been there? Amen. And then there's also these moments where the Lord pulls you in close and tucks you away, because it's a very special moment, because there's a moment he wants to have. And I think both are just as important. They just look different, yet the same, if that makes sense. But in every season, and even the seasons of the trial, it's that secret place. It's the coming through Jesus, what he did, he made a way. It's that place that secret place in the covering of the Lord, in that place of hiding away. And it's really an invitation to experience him, the secret places. The Lord began to speak to me about that today when I was just praying. And he was like, the secret place really is just this, it's an invitation to know me. And his heart, like, he so just longs for us to meet him there. And just speaking for my own life, you know, there's so many moments in the day we take for granted. And I just, today, he was just whispering to me that I'm looking for those who are hungry, who are willing to meet me in the secret place. You know, it's one thing to know me, and it's one thing to show up at church and to do this thing that we call Christian life, but it's another to meet me and to know me. And there's a season coming. I truly believe there's a season coming, and there's a people that are going to begin to raise up, that are going to know, really know him in the secret, that have walked it out. So Lord, just let us be those, that people. And as I was praying, I was looking over you guys tonight and during worship, just seeing what the Lord wanted to do or say tonight. And I just felt the Father's heart just smiling over you guys. And he was like, these are the ones. These are the ones. There's these in this room tonight. They're the ones who are really hungry. And I'm knocking at the door, just like over Johnny. I'm knocking at the door tonight. And it's an invitation to meet me like never before in the secret place. You know, it's the beauty for ashes. The secret place is really that place of the beauty for ashes. In the midst, it's the peace in the midst of the storm. It's the calm in the midst of the trial. It's even just the peace in the midst of exciting times. You know, sometimes things are going really well, and you almost get so in your head, and you're just like, yeah, we got this now. And the Lord brings you to that secret place where you get centered, you know? Sometimes it's the opposite. It's not that you're like, God, are you there? Sometimes you're like walking on this cloud, and then you get in the secret place, and the Lord's like, yeah, we're going to reel this in, sis. Have you ever had those moments? I have. But it is. It's that beauty for ashes. It's that beautiful place of just communion. It's a place of being really real, where you can just let everything out, where nothing is hidden. I was thinking about that today. How funny. You know, it's called the secret place, but yet there's nothing secret about it between the two of you. I thought it was really fun. I think it's because it's just that place between you and him. It's your secret place. But in the midst of the secret place, there's nothing secret. Everything comes out. But yet you're loved. And there's grace. And he is the door, and he makes a way to either get through it, the trial, to get through the storm. To get over yourself, whatever it is that needs to happen. You know, and if to be in the rock is to be in Jesus, because it says Jesus is the rock. And to be in Jesus is to be in the doorway, because he is the door. Then to be there is just to be steps away from the Father. And it's just steps away, and that is the picture of the secret place. I was thinking about two. I was thinking about another. I didn't even look into this in its study, but it just popped in my head a little earlier, and I jotted it down. But that moment when David and Saul, I'm trying to think, was David was hiding from Saul in the cave, right? And then Saul wound up there, but he didn't know David was hiding there. Remember, do y'all remember this? And so he comes into the cave, to go to the bathroom, of all things, if you can only imagine. So while he's going to the bathroom, you know, David cuts off a little piece of his robe, because he could have killed him then, and he didn't. So he cuts off a little piece of his robe, and I believe he tells him, doesn't he? He turns around and he tells him, he says, I could have killed you, but I didn't. And the Lord was speaking to me about how even in the cleft of the rock, in that secret place, it's a place where the Lord will deliver your enemies. And it's that place of prayer. It's a place of trusting him, bringing everything to him in prayer, bringing everything to him in just real honesty, and he will actually deliver your enemies to you. He will deliver your enemies into your hands from that place of the secret place without even you having to do anything. David didn't have to do anything. He was in hiding. In Psalms 91, it says, he that dwells in the secret place shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. He that dwells in the secret place shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You know, to dwell isn't just to visit, but it means to inhabit. God must, we are in a season where God has to become our address. God has to be the place where we live. He has to be the place where we rest. This world is not our home. But we've got to begin to pack up our stuff, get our stuff in order, and begin to move in, and to move in him. To put aside away the things of the world, the day, the age, and to make home in his presence. I had a dream a long time ago, actually. I fell asleep. This was a really long time ago, actually. I think I was like 15, which that would be 15 years ago. That's crazy. But I fell asleep. I think we were having like a worship night or a revival thing. We were doing something, and I fell asleep back there at the sound booth. And in the dream, I think I shared this maybe, but in the dream, I was in this big football field, and I knew there was like a shadow over me. And I looked to the left, and there was Pastor Tim was standing there. I'm sorry, y'all, my allergies just got me. And then I looked to the right, and Bob Jones was standing there. And I turned behind me, and there was this just crowd of youth. I mean, like thousands of youth in this football stadium. And when I looked up above us, I could tell something was over us. And when I looked over us, it was this huge wing. And then it flashed, and I saw this picture of this DNA spinning. And then I woke up. And when I read this scripture, he that dwells in the secret place shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I immediately saw that picture in my head from that dream that I had. And I really do believe that there is a generation rising up, and I don't think it's just going to be youth. I think it's just going to be a mixture of people. It's just going to be a people that are in love with the Lord. But those that have been in the secret place and understand his heart in the secret place. And I just want to, I'm going to sing this little song over you guys. It's by Jesse Rogers. It's an old song from a long time ago, but it's so good. It's called Untame My Heart. So untame my heart and cause me to run while I'm free in the love you have for me. And open my eyes, let me look upon your beauty as if it was the first time I'd see. Let me see you again. Let me love you. Close your eyes for a minute, and I'm going to just sing this over again. Lord, as we, just as these people in this room, Lord, as we join together tonight, Lord, raise up, Lord, people, Lord, after your heart, Lord, the ones who will meet you in the secret place whenever you call. Lord, come tonight and untame our hearts. Lord, come and play your love song over us, the one that captures our heart and pulls us in. Your eyes on him. Cause me to run wild and free in the love you have for me. And open my eyes. Let me look upon your beauty as if it was the first time I'd seen it. Let me see. Dwell with you all of my days. dance with me again, and let the angels tell each other heaven's playing our song. Wrap me in your arms, sweep me off my feet into your presence, ravished by you, ravished by you. As I'm just singing this, I really felt like there's a real opportunity to really allow this to be a key in your life, to just open up your hearts for a minute. And it's that moment of fixing in on Him. We've been doing this in the youth while we're worshiping, just training ourselves how to get out of our mind and really just fix in on the Father. Lord, where are you at? What are you doing? Lord, what's in the room? What's going on? And I've really felt just the real easy access to grab a hold of this. And I guess what I'm seeing is just the ability to enter the secret place just in your everyday life, a real easy access, that it's not going to be something you have to try at. Ooh. Lord, just release your angels in this room to come and do a work in our hearts. Lord, come and do whatever you want to do in this room tonight. Lord, as you prepare our hearts, as you prepare a generation, Lord, to know you and walk with you like never before. So dance with me again. Let the angels tell each other heaven's playing our song. Today, whenever I was laying there and just preparing, and June was laying there, and I was kind of telling her what I was praying about and what I was speaking about on the secret place and how hiding away? And she said, yeah, it's kind of like hide and seek. And I was like, yeah, it is kind of like hide and seek. And I just began to think about when I was little. You remember when you were little and you would play in hide and seek and you'd just find that really great spot and you'd just kind of nestle in. You're like, they're never going to find me here. You know, and you may find a kind of decent spot, but you were always ready. Like, you were kind of anxious and ready and prepared. But, you know, when you find that really good spot, then you could just be like, okay, I'm good. Like, I'm just going to chill out because they're never going to find me. A funny story. I'll tell a little story. One time I was young. I was probably like 8, I guess, and my little cousin. We were playing hide and seek. So we were all hiding. It was like a big game of hide and seek. My whole family was playing. And I think Bailey at the time was like 3. I probably shouldn't have said her name because she probably did. I don't know if she wants to know me to tell the story, but she'll be fine. So apparently she was 3 and we were playing hide and seek, but she had found her way into the art cabinet and she had gotten all these markers out and like tattooed her whole body up with markers. So all while we were playing hide and seek, so everybody's searching and looking. Meanwhile, Bailey's covered in markers. So then she got real nervous. So she thought, I really need to find a better hiding place. So she buried herself down in this trunk full of dress-up clothes, closed the trunk, and she was like under the clothes. So we're all playing hide and seek, and at this, we you know, everybody's been found, but we can't find Bailey, and she's like 3, and everybody's kind of freaking out. And she was notorious for going out the front door, like going on walks, you know, just little leisurely walks here and there, just because she felt like it. And so we all kind of freaked out. We thought, well, maybe she had gotten out, left, and wandering the neighborhood. So I remember getting on my bike and searching the neighborhood, trying to find her. And it was probably, they called the police. The police came, found a missing child report. It was a big mess. About 5 hours later, we're searching and somebody sees this little like shoelace hanging out of the thing. And they were like, and I think it was pink. So, and she had had him on because it was pretty, they knew. Anyways, they pick and grab her, and they pull her up out by the foot, and she's fallen asleep. She had fallen asleep in there hiding in this just safe little comfortable place, and she was just resting, chilling with her tattooed up body and her washable markers in her hiding place. But I just got to thinking about that, and what a sweet that it is kind of like hiding. It is kind of like hide and seek in a way, and I just as I was thinking about that, just could feel the Father laughing. And you know, I think He loves for us to seek after Him, and He loves to seek after us. He loves when we're hungry and we're thirsty, and we pull on Him, and we ask for more. And we ask questions about Him. We ask, what's going on, Lord? How's your day? He loves that. But I think He loves doing the same for us. He loves to seek us out. He loves to chase us down. That there's nothing that can hold Him back from us. There's nothing that can change His love. And I was just thinking about that and just that place, secret place, just hiding away, just searching for Him. Lord, where are You at? Like, I can't wait to meet You here. And this song popped in my head, so I'm just going to sing it over you guys.
So I will wait for You, Jesus. You're the sun in my horizon. All my hope's in You, Jesus. I can see You now arising, so I will wait for You, 'cause Jesus, You're the sun in my horizon, and all my hope's in You, Jesus. I can see You now.
could just hear Jesus laughing of us, over us. And just this sweet game, almost, of I just can't wait to find you and I can't wait to see what's on your heart. There's real joy in the secret place. Just give us a love for our brothers and sisters, Lord, to see the beauty of who you are in one another. We can see you now, rising up. Let us be the ones. Oh, fresh out of the secret place. Let us be a fragrant offering. Let us be the one. I really felt as I was praying. And we'll just end with this. I felt like here's a real season of the Lord is about to release creativity like never before. That there are new songs, there are new sounds, there's new books, there's pictures, there's movies, inventions, dances, books, jobs that are about to come out. I could just see them almost like gifts, like in the spirit, just looking for somewhere to rest, for shoulders to rest on. And the Lord said it'll be the ones, they're going to come from the secret place. And I kept hearing, my yoke is easy, my burden is light. And I feel like the Lord is going to begin to shift us out of a place of trying to do the things in ourselves and come up with new songs in ourselves and new books in ourselves and new jobs or weights, just things, inventions. We're going to get out of the mindset of doing it on our own. But he said that when we're in that place, in that secret place, that they're just going to be like gifts handed over. I kept just hearing him say, meet me in the secret place. So if y'all don't mind, if you want that, just open up your hands and we're just going to pray into that. Lord, just release your creativity in this room. Lord, new songs, new gifts. Lord, new books. Lord, even new jobs. Lord, new ideas. Lord, I thank you that we're going to find you in the secret place. Lord, I thank you that your yoke is easy and your burden is light. Lord, and we lay down, Lord, anything that we've tried to pick up on our own and to do on our own, Lord, and I thank you that it's going to be so easy, Lord, for your children as we enter into that secret place and we begin to know you and walk like never before in the secret place. Lord, I thank you for the gifts and treasures to begin to be released, Lord. We really felt like the Lord just wanted us to have journals, have our pens and papers ready when you meet with them. And just to begin to write it down, to write the vision down. Another night I had a dream. It was really interesting. And in this dream, I was walking down the aisles of Bass Pro Shop. And I was walking down and I was kind of have my gaze set ahead, like in front of me, just wasn't looking at to the left or the right, and I was walking, but I was running my hands down the aisle, this aisle on either side, and I recognized something that felt really familiar on the left. So I turned, and when I looked, it was a bow and a satchel of arrows. And it was like it fit to my every fingerprint. Like even it was like edged with my fingerprint. And I just began to feel like I just began to just like admire the woodwork and everything that was on it. And I heard somebody call my name and I turned and it was a friend of mine from high school, but his name was Benjamin. And he said, Amanda, is there anything that I can help you with? And I said, yeah, can I get this one? Or can I try this out, please? And he said, yeah, sure. And so he takes me to this big arena, it's like an arena practice zone. And so I pick this bow and arrow, I grab an arrow, and I pull it back, and I let it go. And in the dream, I knew I had never shot a bow and arrow before. And it released, the arrow like flew forward like with such accuracy and like hit the bullseye. Like I didn't even have to try. And I looked back at him, and he looked at me, and he said, yeah, I think that one's yours. And I was like, okay. And so I turned back around, and when I turned back around, we were in this huge field, and there was nothing in front of me. It was just this field in front. So I turned back around to look at him because it's like the scenery had changed. And when I did, he was standing there, but in front of this crowd of people again, and it was very similar to like what I had in the past dream. But there's a crowd of youth, and there were some older people there, and there were some young kids there. There was just a mixed array of people, but there were just thousands of them. I'm trying to remember what happened, which part happened next. And so as I looked, he looked at me and he said, "Are you ready?" And as he did, these two rocks, they were like boulders that were standing on either side of the youth or this group of people. I noticed there were a lot of youth, but there were a few of an older generation. There were a few kids, but there were a lot of youth in the group. But these boulders stood up, and they were about three times taller than all the people, and they had these huge smiles on their face. And there, it was like these big rock guys. And as they stood up, I was looking and I was thinking, what in the world is this? And this, it's like the wind blew and the wind said, all creation's groaning, all creation has been longing for the sons of men to be released. And I looked up the scripture, and in the Message version, it has a really cool version of that scripture, and it says that all creation is waiting to be released, that all creation is waiting for the Father to say it's time. And I thought, that's really cool. So in my dream, these guys stood up, the wind blew, and I heard all creation's groaning for the sons of God to be released. And when I heard the wind say that, it's like all of a sudden this whole group of people just erupted into this shout of praise, and I woke up. That's what I was trying to remember where I was going with that. And so, but in the dream, the Lord began to speak to me that that he's come to give us the weapons, the tools, the gifts, the things that we need, that he's come to give them to us. And it's not going to be something that we're even looking for, and it's not something we're going to have to be a strive for, but they've already been prepared for us, and they've been made for us. And it was just like at Bass Pro, I was just running my hands down this aisle, and it was like literally my fingers connected. But the Lord's about to begin to release the tools and the things that we need for this next season, and that all creation is waiting and groaning for us to begin to walk in what we're called to walk in. And we're called to be the ones of the secret place. And that's where all the answers are going to be. That's where the tools lie. It's where the gifts, it's where the songs, everything that we need are going to be in the secret place. So Lord, I just bless, Lord, I thank you for these people. Lord, I thank you for your children that are here tonight. Lord, I thank you for just this sweet night of just rest. Lord, even like we talked about, just being tucked away, Lord, I even feel just this sweet presence of being tucked away tonight. Lord, I thank you that you've come and you've just stirred our heart, Lord, to meet you. Lord, I thank you that we can meet you. It doesn't matter. It doesn't have to be this dramatic thing, Lord, but I thank you that you're bringing us into a season of secret place encounters, Lord, in everyday life. Lord, as I give my babies a bath, Lord, I pray that you would just surround and that you would fill the atmosphere. Lord, as we go about our day, Lord, as the teachers who are teaching, Lord, as the men who are working to provide, Lord, I thank you for the secret place encounters. Lord, for the nurses who are nursing. Lord, I thank you for deep revelation, Lord, going to be released, Lord, in our everyday, just in the everyday lives. That there will be key things, Lord, that you're going to begin to release when we never expected it. Just because we said, hey, Lord, how are you doing? What's on your heart? And you're going to speak. Lord, will you ever be on our mind? Would you ever be on our hearts, Lord? Always, Lord, would our every thought be placed on you, Lord. Begin to train us up, Lord. I know we're so far from it, and it seems unreachable sometimes, but Lord, I thank you that it's not. I thank you that tonight is the beginning and it's about to get easier. Lord, as we open our hearts to you tonight, that you've come tonight, Lord, you've released your angels tonight to work on our hearts, Lord, to minister to your children. Lord, you've given us the keys. Lord, we receive the keys tonight. Lord, we receive everything that we need to really begin to dive into your word, to dive into that place, Lord, that's knowing you more than yesterday. Lord, I bless them as they go home. Lord, I bless them as they go about their day tomorrow. Lord, we just pray that you'd release miracles, signs, and wonders throughout their day as they step out. Lord, I thank you for your heart. I thank you for your invitation to know you more. Lord, come and untame our hearts tonight. And I pray for dreams tonight, Lord, that you would give each and every one in here dreams. Lord, key dreams that they need, Lord, for this season, for the times to come. In Jesus' name, amen. Are y'all awake? Good. Love you guys. Thank y'all.